Here's how to learn technical things fast. As a business intelligence engineer, I am constantly learning new things, and over time, I've developed these 5 tips that have really helped me learn pretty much anything new. So today, I'll be sharing what those 5 tips are so that you can start learning anything easily. The first is change up your environment. When I'm working at home, I spend about 8 hours at my desk, but my desk is conveniently located right next to my bed, so I'm spending pretty much all day in the same room. And when it comes time for me to intensely focus to learn, I find myself super distracted and unable to focus because I'm just way too comfortable in my environment. If the weather's nice, I'll take about a 10 to 30 minute walk outside, and that's a really good study break for me to freshen up and clear my mind. And research has actually shown that taking a nature walk improves our cognitive abilities as well as our ability to problem solve and creatively think. And I think it's so true because I always feel better after taking that walk. And if I don't end up going outdoors, what I will do is I'll physically take my laptop and go work in the living room or go to a coffee shop, and that really allows me to focus by changing it up so that I'm not too comfortable in my environment and can get so much more done when I change my scenery. The second tip I found is to give yourself limited time. Parkinson's law says that we work to fill the amount of time available. If we know we have a whole month to learn something new, we will take that whole month to learn, even if it may be something that could be done in a week. And I found that this holds true for pretty much anything. Have you noticed that when a meeting is set for an hour, it takes the full hour, or a 30-minute meeting takes the full 30 minutes, even when the agenda may have been shorter? We tend to fill the time to fill the space. This also happens when you're studying for an exam and you're studying up until the last minute, when it's probably something you could have learned in less time. And I do this as well when I'm learning a new tool at work. I will spend the weeks learning it when honestly I could have done it in a day. To eliminate this habit of filling the time, I will schedule short deadlines for myself. I usually schedule a time block where I know that if I exceed that amount, I will not get it done. That sense of urgency I create for myself allows me to not be as easily distracted on my phone, start wandering around, and really just focus on my task and get it done within that time. I noticed this technique especially worked when I was preparing for the Amazon interviews, and data modeling was something I didn't know very much, and I had to prepare for the interviews. So I spent a day intensely focusing on data modeling concepts as well as practicing how I would do it. And during the interviews the following day, I was able to talk about it so naturally. So this is an example where I've seen when I have short periods of time that I need to get something done, I will get it done, and it makes me learn something way quicker. And a tip I used while learning was say it out loud. Research has shown that you're more likely to remember something if you read it out loud. They call it the production effect, where the concept of reading it out loud as well as hearing it makes you remember things way faster. This is a great trick to learn, and I do this all the time at work, where if someone is explaining something new to me, then I will sit there and say it back out loud, and that does 2 things. The first is it confirms my understanding of what they said, and it reinforces my learning by saying it back in my own words. And I think about Albert Einstein's quote, "If you can't explain it simply, then you don't understand it well enough." Take anything new you learn and try to explain it at a 5th grade language level. I do this very often, and it's a communication tip when you're talking to non-technical audiences, where I take something really technical and I can distill it down to really simple language that pretty much anyone can understand. So when you're learning something new, try teaching someone else. Tell a friend, a family member, explain what you learned back to them, and that act of retrieving the information will help you learn the new concept. Or just talk to yourself. This is what I do commonly. I just summarize the information back in my words, and this process of repeating it back to even myself really helps me retain the information. And another tip that helps with reinforcement is test yourself a lot. Self-testing is one of the best ways to speed up the learning process, especially when you're testing yourself and you find that you got an answer wrong. You're going to remember it after you spent the time looking it up, but also you remember it because you know it's something that you got wrong. And so I self-test myself a lot, especially when I'm preparing for technical interviews. I use platforms like LeetCode and Interview Query to test my knowledge of technical questions as well as for practice. By doing practice exams, I get used to answering technical questions and I identify the gaps I have, which helps me learn. I also recommend doing coding challenges like on Kaggle. They often have competitions where you can really test yourself, as well as projects is a great way to get hands-on real-world experience and test your knowledge of your technical skills and be able to apply them in a real-world situation. And that helps you really build upon your skills and challenge yourself in a different way. Now you may be thinking, how many technical skills do I need to know? With AI coming, with job descriptions adding more technical things to the list, and for career advancement, they're always asking you to learn new skills, and it becomes overwhelming that you're constantly having to learn. This is where the 80-20 rule comes in, and I found that it works great when learning anything new because it means that 20% of your effort leads to 80% of your results. As in, rather than focusing on learning 100% of everything, I only focus on learning the most important skills as well as the fundamental concepts, so the 20% that will get me 80% of the results that I need. So as a business intelligence engineer, I use the 80-20 rule to pick and choose the skill sets that I know will have the greatest impact on my role. So that includes cloud technology as well as BI visualization tools and learning some AI, and not choosing to learn other programming languages like Java because I just know that that doesn't add as much of a value to my role today. And I still use the 80-20 rule as I'm learning the skill. So when I came to Amazon, I had no idea what QuickSight was, which is basically Amazon's version of Tableau. And learning the tool was at first overwhelming, but I thought, why not learn the fundamentals first? So that 20%. And just by taking a 2-hour course to learn how to use QuickSight, I was able to create a dashboard for a customer, creating visualizations based off the little bit that I knew. I would say, as you learn, just focus on learning the fundamentals, and that will get you most of the way there, and you can continue to build upon your knowledge as you continue to learn more skills. Now that you know how to learn technical things fast, watch my next video as I talk about 5 high-paying data jobs, including their salaries. Thank you so much, and please like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed this video.